How American Thanksgiving Day started. Thanksgiving is the day of the year that gets American families to come together and share in a long-standing tradition that dates back hundreds of years. Although this year's Thanksgiving is set to be quite different from all others we've celebrated before, odds are we'll make it as special as ever this time around. But why do we celebrate Thanksgiving in the first place? Where does this timeless tradition come from, and what are some of the most common Thanksgiving traditions in today's American culture? We'll cover that and more in today's video. There are some dark theories about its origins that most historians are reluctant to admit. But before we begin, please be sure to subscribe to our channel and hit the like and bell icon for more upcoming videos. What is Thanksgiving? Thanksgiving is an American holiday that is celebrated every fourth Thursday of the month of November, which means that it can only be held on November 22nd through 28th. This is one of the most family-centric celebrations in the entire year, and it involves sharing, getting together with the extended family, and eating a lot. We'll go over all the funny and quirky things we like to do during Thanksgiving in a moment, but first, let's see what this national holiday is really supposed to mean. What does Thanksgiving mean? This American holiday is supposed to be a continuation of a harvest feast held by the Pilgrims in Plymouth, New England, back in 1621. It's actually quite common that people in the old world thank God every time they have a good harvest, because it simply meant that they wouldn't die of hunger. And in fact, many other cultures around the world hold similar celebrations, as you'll learn by the end of this video. But in the case of the American tradition, there was one event in 1621 that made the year's harvest feast different from all the others. A big group of Wampanoag natives showed up at the Pilgrim settlement gate and completely freaked out the Pilgrims, as they thought they were about to be attacked. The natives ended up joining in on the fun, however, and they ate and drank and partied the night away for 3 days straight, old school style. The ties of this friendship formed during those days lasted for 10 years, until war broke out. While that's generally the accepted view of what happened in 1621, some historians have a different take on things, as you're about to find out next. A darker Thanksgiving story. An expert on Native American history, Dr. Jack Dempsey, paints a different picture of the reasons behind the event of 1621. He states that the Wampanoag didn't show up unannounced as a friendly bunch in search of a good time, but rather as a consequence of mutual agreement to help out each other through the dire times in which war wasn't in anyone's best interest. Fact is that neither party trusted the other. But the Pilgrims were particularly mistrusting of the Native Americans, who vastly outnumbered them. One key event that is conveniently struck out of the story is that only 2 years after the first Thanksgiving feast, Captain Miles Standish tricked the Massachusetts tribe into coming to the settlement as guests. Then he killed all of them and mounted the leader's head on a spike in the fort out of fear of an imminent attack from the tribe. It sort of puts the whole 10 years of peace and quiet theory under perspective, doesn't it? Either way, it was during the Civil War in 1863 that Abraham Lincoln proclaimed the last Thursday of November as a National Thanksgiving Day, and Roosevelt in 1941, who rolled it back 1 week to the fourth Thursday in November in order to extend the Christmas shopping season. Thanksgiving traditions. Thanksgiving is deeply rooted in America, and it brings about warm memories and a lot of family nostalgia, more than any other holidays, in fact. The reason behind it is that Thanksgiving is always celebrated with a series of traditions, some more widespread across the country and others more local or personal. And here are the top 7 Thanksgiving traditions in the United States. Number 7, watch an American football game. Ever since 1876, shortly after our favorite game was invented, Americans have upheld the tradition of watching a professional football game on Thanksgiving Day, or even play a game themselves in the backyard if enough friends and family show up. Number 6. Break the wishbone for good luck. Part of the turkey tradition involves the wishbone in the turkey carcass. Two people each grab a side and break the bone apart while making a wish. Whoever breaks off the larger part of the wishbone will have their wish granted. Number 5. Run a turkey trot. While not every family indulges in this tradition, there are many towns across the country that hold runs, walks, and half marathons to burn off those extra slices of apple pies and pumpkin pies. Number 4. Shop like mad on Black Friday and Cyber Monday. Black Friday is the day after Thanksgiving, and has been regarded since 1952 as the beginning of the Christmas shopping season. The explanation typically given for the day's name is that it is the first day of the year that retailers are in the black as opposed to being in the red. Because of this, it is traditional for stores all over the country, and now all over the Western world, to offer big discounts on their products to lure customers in to kick off the season of lots and lots of shopping. A similar tradition started to gain traction in the late 1990s and early 2000s for the e-commerce industry, the Cyber Monday, which has become more and more popular as the online shopping day for nearly 2 decades now on the Monday following Thanksgiving Day. Number 3. The traditional presidential turkey party. Every year, tens of millions of turkeys are slaughtered for Thanksgiving dinners. And for ages, the President of the US has been presented 3 turkeys, 2 of them dressed in costumes for his own feast. But JFK spared his turkey in 1963, and it became a thing for presidents. Ronald Reagan jokingly issued an official presidential pardon to his turkey in 1987, and President George H.W. Bush instituted the official turkey pardon as a presidential tradition from 1988 onwards. And all the presidents since have happily complied, sending the lucky feathered friends to a petting zoo. Number 2. Watch the Macy's Thanksgiving Day Parade. Along with the Christmas Parade, New York Macy's Thanksgiving Parade is one of the country's biggest and most popular traditional parades, with thousands of onlookers and millions of TV spectators admiring huge inflatable balloons floating amid the city skyscrapers. Number 1. Eat a traditional Thanksgiving meal. While some families may not share all of the 6 traditions we just mentioned, there's one that absolutely no American family can ever do without, and that is having a traditional Thanksgiving dinner, no matter how big or small it may be. The star of the night is always the turkey, but there are a lot of other delicious dishes that are also popular choices. Keep watching and see which dishes are your family's traditions too, and which ones are not. What Americans eat on Thanksgiving. Food is an integral and very important part of any holiday or celebration, but it's especially important on Thanksgiving. Here's a list of the 10 most traditional dishes Americans enjoy during this late November celebration. If you are American, you'll likely tick all these items off the list. Number 10, roasted turkey, obviously. This is the star of the show, and every family competes to make the tastiest, juiciest turkey they can every year to impress everyone in the family and the guests. Even those who live alone or can't otherwise be at the dinner table will likely get a turkey sandwich or something similar, just to keep with tradition. Number 9. Gravy and stuffing. Each family has their own secret recipe for the gravy and stuffing that go with the turkey. And this in itself is a cherished family tradition. Although no 2 stuffings are the same, most include breadcrumbs, apple cranberries, and spices. Number 8. Mashed potatoes. Ubiquitous in almost all Thanksgiving dinners, mashed potatoes are the perfect complement to gravy. Or is it the other way around? Number 7. Sweet potato casserole. Sweet potatoes are also a popular choice to go with turkey, and by far the most popular way to serve them is in a casserole, sometimes topped with marshmallows. It's not what we would call light, but hey, Thanksgiving is only once a year. Number 6. Cornbread and dinner rolls. Some may consider it rude, but nothing beats wiping our plate clean of gravy with a freshly baked piece of cornbread or a dinner roll. Number 5. Butternut squash. Just like sweet potatoes, butternut squash is another popular choice when it comes to adding a sweet and unctuous garnish to a big slice of turkey. Number 4. Cranberry sauce, jellied or not. Many sweet garnishes go well with roasted turkey and mashed potatoes, and cranberry sauce is one of them. Some families add some extra gelatin or pectin to make a firmer jellied cranberry sauce that can actually be cut into slices. Number 3. Apple pie. This is an all-American traditional dessert, and it's sure to be a part of most Thanksgiving dinners. Number 2. Spiced apples. Thanksgiving is near the end of the apple harvesting season, so it's traditional to have many apple-based dishes. Spiced apples are the choice many Americans make when they want this fruit to be the protagonist. Number 1. Pumpkin pie. No Thanksgiving dinner is complete without a slice of the sweet and creamy traditional pumpkin pie. Thanksgiving dinner is also usually washed down with a ginger cranberry sparkler, applejack mulled cider, or some version of a fall flavors punch. Making and drinking eggnog is also a very popular family tradition, and some families make a whole batch to last throughout Christmas, all the way until New Year's Eve. What other countries celebrate Thanksgiving or similar holidays? Believe it or not, the United States isn't the only country that celebrates some form of a Thanksgiving tradition. There are numbers of other countries that celebrate their own version of Thanksgiving, giving it literally the same name, for example in Canada, while others celebrate a very similar holiday that has equivalent roots to the American version. Let's quickly look at five of them from around the world. Number 5. China Zongxiu. The Chinese hold a 3-day harvest moon festival on the 15th day of the 8th month of the lunar cycle. They light their traditional lanterns and eat mooncake. Number 4. Japan's Kinro Kanshi Nohi. This celebration commemorates the harvesting of rice on November 23rd, but today is meant as a day when hard work is acknowledged by the Japanese. In fact, the literal transition is Labor Thanksgiving Day. Number 3. South India's Pongal. In South India, they celebrate a 4-day harvest festival called Pongal. They dedicate each day to a different god with different offerings of traditional foods. They paint cows and they get together for a family feast on the 4th day. Number 2. Malaysia's Kaamatan. The Malaysian equivalent to Thanksgiving is one of the few that don't happen in October through November. There, they celebrate and give thanks for the end of the rice harvest season in May, and they'll dance, drink rice wine, and have buffalo races. Number 1. Germany's Erntedankfest. The first Sunday of October, Germans and other Europeans celebrate the Erntedankfest, or Harvest Thanks Festival. They do it in public in towns while parading, instead of at home with their families, and there's no turkey involved. Out of all the traditions and traditional dishes that we Americans hold dear to our hearts, which ones are more popular in your family's Thanksgiving? And did it surprise you to see that other countries also celebrate Thanksgiving? Let us know in the comments section below, and don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the bell icon for more interesting videos. Until next time, thanks for watching.